Thank you very much. I think I'm not quite happy to be advocatus diaboli. Let's do it in a different way. Here I'm at advocatus diaboli. Hopefully you have prepared the protocol or a taping of the proposals which have been made by my three predecessors here on the panel, because here you have a very comprehensive list of subjects for the Center for Advanced Studies where research has to be done and where you have to develop some exercises and so on and so on. I think it would be extremely important. Hopefully it's happening. Second, I want to contradict Vedran. I think the Danube region is not instead of the Regional Cooperation Council.
No.
It is quite a different subject and it has to be understood. The Regional Cooperation Council is a political instrument because it's depending on the Southeast European cooperative process, which was not already mentioned. I think it is an exercise to bring the countries more together because we have a lot of bilateral problems, multilateral problems, and so on and so on. And the EU Union, European Union strategy on the Danube region, horrible abbreviation, I think has to focus to bring the countries together on specified subjects. I think I'm always using the way to express it, it is a mosaic where we are putting pieces together. I think we need to have a vision, we have to an imagination how she should it like, and so we are trying by the Danube strategy to put the things together, combined with the philosophy or the vision that the river is bringing us together, which was the case with the River Rhine, because for sure France and Germany and the Benelux countries were brought together in a certain way, and the Rhine is not anymore a border. I think hopefully the Danube will be quite soon not anymore a border. I think it's by majority still a border, because we have a lot of problems along. I'm always mentioning the famous bridge story concerning Bulgaria and Romania, 470 kilometers. We had only one bridge, now we have a second bridge, but the roads to go to the bridge are not anymore existing. So far, I think you can see what's quite necessary. But there is a mind behind. I was very much criticizing my Romanian friends and they said to me, you have to understand, the Danube is still the border of the Ottoman Empire. Mm-hmm. In the year 2013, I don't want to blame the Romanians, but there is something in the head. And I think that's very important also for the center to deal with this subject. Back to democracy. I told you yesterday about the Institute of the Humanities, Institute für die Wissenschaften von Menschen, very much focusing on democracy. I think one of the subjects of the center should be not to elaborate the differences, but the development was quite a different one. First of all, by the Balkan Wars, for sure, but also by some positive developments. I want to mention the positive developments. I don't know if I'm allowed to mention Ivo Sanader here in Croatia, but he turned around his party, being pro-European. I'm not a fan of HDZ, I'm not a fan of one of the Croatian parties because it's not my job, but I think it had some results. And it has to be examined because sometimes there's always a danger to get a setback. To give you another example, I think what Vučić is doing now in Serbia is really excellent, and I think it should be done a lot of research concerning how the things are going on, Serbia, Kosovo, and so on and so on, because even such a research might be a support for those what is happening here. I'm coming from Tirana. There was a danger of the usual situation. If the government changes, the predecessor is blocking everything of the successor, or vice versa, what's going on. It's looking like that it's a little bit better. We have no demonstration about the election results. We have only that the Democratic Party is keeping out of the parliament for the moment. I think here I'm asking you to do some exercise about the behavior of the European member states. I repeat, European member states, not the European Commission. I think I'm defending the European Commission. I think this is a long list because the European member states are not anymore really looking to Southeast Europe. That's not only concerning money, okay, all with the money, but look to the real subjects. I think I feel blamed as a European that nobody was putting pressure on our Greek friends concerning Macedonia, that the state name case is still a problem. We have to put pressure on the Macedonians because the Kurevski government is doing every nonsense possible in the main place of Skopje, spending a lot of money on heroes and so on and so on. And the economic situation and the social situation is extremely bad.
Yeah, it's a criticism existing.
Nothing. Everybody's looking elsewhere, but not here. I think here, that's only one of the examples. The Dayton Agreement was a very good result concerning finishing a war, but it was not a constitution for Bosnia-Herzegovina. And here, I think we have either to push the Europeans and the Americans, because they have a certain responsibility on this, to change their attitude, and we have to put pressure on the different groups within Bosnia-Herzegovina, because they are responsible that they have really no common government. I think I was very often campaigning for investment in Bosnia-Herzegovina, even some assistance. I will never forget the scene. We got some money by the Deutsche Bundesbahn for improving the railway system in Bosnia-Herzegovina. Here, you can imagine, Prime Minister, CEO of the Republika Srpska Railway, CEO of the Federation Railway. The Germans brought the money. I was assisting them there. And it was not possible to get an agreement how it is used. After 2 hours, my German friend says, bye-bye, we are taking our money and they are off. Okay, that's the situation. And I think here you have to do some research on the decision-making and how the things are going on, because it's of extreme importance that we are getting other results. Thank you very much for very often mentioning the question of migration and brain circulation. I think here the center has to do, for sure, a lot of things. Also on the open bounds, Srebrenica, I think we all know it. Recently, I was doing an activity in Vukovar. I think obviously it's coming on that the Lika is also an increasing problem here. I think we have to look at this. Not only, I think, to speak, okay, reconciliation. The state presidents did their job. The problem of reconciliation is a little bit more down, not on the state presidents only. Okay, that they did it. Thank you, I have to say. But what is the mood behind? I'm as a chair of the Center for Democracy and Reconciliation in Southeast Europe. It did a marvelous job concerning the history books of the region. It's a nightmare if you're looking there, because you have Greater Romania, Greater Bulgaria, Greater Greece, Greater Serbia, Greater whatever you want. And I'm always saying I'm born in Greater Germany as an Austrian and I know what the result was. I think on this we have to focus. We are doing also vicinities. This is our TV presentations of neighborhood. I think it is of extreme importance that the region is learning that they are neighbors, which for sure is not yet happening. And it is difficult to understand for outside. And don't forget the real problem is that it was for a very long time, nearly at every time, it was one state. It was partly Ottoman Empire, it was partly Habsburg Empire, it was partly Yugoslavia. But I think now the ideologies of obviously differentiation. As I was posted for the Southeast European Cooperative Initiative, my American friend said to me, you have to do something that the border stations are not so big. At places where never has been a border. I think we have to be aware of this with a little knowledge of history. I have always the feeling if I'm passing by, we are passing through borders which not existed in the past, which are now actually. And I think we have also to fight this border mentality, which for sure is existing. It's still existing. Today I will pass from here to the Slovenian border in a Croatian car. I'm quite sure the Slovenians will have a tougher look to us, because they are always doing so. If I'm behind the Slovenian car, I have to wait longer at the Croatian border, and vice versa if it is the other way around. There's something behind in the mentality. It's not to blame the people. Please don't misunderstand me. But this is a very important subject, even it might go to psychopathology in a certain way. But okay, coming from the city of Sigmund Freud, I have a closer relation to all these questions. But I think we have to be aware on this. That's the sense of the Danube strategy, that on different subjects, as Miroslav Vesković has outlined it, people are working together and forgetting what they have against the other with the lack of knowledge, that they are trying to have common results on this and to work on this together. I think it's a training subject, hopefully with results quite soon. I think the last but one remark, we have also to look to the strategies appearing. It's very interesting, I'm meeting two states of importance having an Eurasia strategy. The one are my dear friends of Russia, they are doing it with a free trade zone, Kazakhstan, Belarus, Armenia, now they are trying to bring in Ukraine with a lot of pressure. Or a certain strategy, I think we have to be aware as Europeans. Yeah. But the Turkish friends are doing the same, Central Asia and so on and so on. I think I invited the new Prime Minister Edi Rama for an investment event in Vienna, and nicely he said to me, you have to understand, I cannot go there, because we are invited by Prime Minister Erdogan to have a meeting, different prime ministers and so on and so on. There's a certain strategy, I think. It's not only pure friendship by the Turks. I'm always admiring the three bridges here in Belgrade, newly done. One of the European Union, one of the Russian Federation, one of the Chinese. Here you can see a certain strategy, which for sure is existing. Here the Danube River is coming in a very interesting and challenging ways. I think so far the region is of a huge interest, but we have to do also strategy. Okay, let's take the money from where it might come, but the region has to develop a common strategy and a common feeling in which direction we are moving. The last remark is, please focus on the question of medias. I had recently, last week in Sarajevo, a meeting of the Southeast Europe Media Organization. I went out with depressions, because they all told me the media situation is more worse than in the last 10 years. Because the freedom of the media is not existing, the influence of the government, the influence of the oligarchs, and so on and so on. You have to do some exercise on this. You won't gain friends by this, but I think it's for sure a necessity concerning the chapter of democracy which we are dealing here now. So far, there's a lot of to do here. We have to deal with, I forgot one question. I think for Europe, the region has one importance about the mixed presence of religions. I think don't underestimate it. In the western part of Europe, we are forgetting on the religion, being secularized, besides some fundamentalistic groups, which are appearing in my Catholic Church, for example, or also in others. But on the other side, we have a certain influence also by religion, which is here done. It's not for guarantee that peace is coming after this. I think we have to do a lot of exercise here. That's not only the question that we have to convince everybody that he has to be pious or she. I think it is of great importance how we are handling it. I'm blaming the European Union on the subject that we were not able to discuss the subject of the European Islam. I think one of the contributions of the past of Austria is this law on the Muslims of the Hanafi ritus concerning Bosnia, because it was the only one existing regulation where the things are organized, and my country is gaining a lot of it. I will never forget, as a minister I was also in charge of religious affairs, the president of the Muslim community, by law they are forced to vote for a president. It's typical for the old Habsburg monarchy. The emperor wanted to have a partner. So far, we had to choose somebody who is in charge of this. And this is a nice man, and this time it was a policeman of Vienna, being a Pakistani, and he said to me, concerning the scarf, Excellency Minister, Minister Excellency, we need a solution. I said, what's your proposal? Viennese proposal. Nice Viennese proposal. I said, what is your proposal? I think the Mufti shall distribute the scarf at the beginning of the religious undervising and collect it afterwards and put it off. And shall close here, that it is here behind. I think the solution is still working. I think it's not a solution for Europe, I may say, but we have to deal with this, because otherwise then we are getting all the discussions about mosques, minarets, and so on and so on. It will come out. The approach of my German friends concerning Turkey has a special view on the subject, which we shall not underestimate it. But I think Turkey has to be the one or the other way a partner. It's extremely important. It makes no sense to make a lot of meetings about Arab Spring if you are not dealing with Turkey. Turkey is a partner there. I'm not really convinced that they are able to handle the Arab Spring out of historical reasons, because they were a colonial power in this part. But I think here we have to create some mechanisms which are not existing. So far, I think it is a huge list of projects which you can do. My last advice is please tender it, that we might find capacities in the region who are able to do it, because sometimes it's more existing as we are knowing.